I've always felt, and I always will, that St. John's and the NYPD and the FDNY are part of the fabric of this great city.
How was your experience out here? Let's start at the firehouse.
Firehouse, you know, was great. You know, got to see a lot of firefighters. You know, some of them actually came during the call of 9/11. So, you know, it's just great to meet them. We always give support.
Did you know there's a lot of St. John's who passed away here? How do you feel about that?
I didn't know until Ron, our trainer, told me. So, you know, that's actually, you know, actually it connects us all almost. You know, everybody I feel like is connected to St. John's now. I didn't know that till today. So, you know, it's just breathtaking.
In the first 2 or 3 hours, 10% of the fatalities were St. John's alumni. The list just kept coming in, and people that we knew, that we're going to go down and see him today. The captain of our baseball team was a very famous firefighter, and he passed away, Mike Weinberg. And our captain of our swimming team previously, he passed away that day as part of the police department. So the next 4 or 5 days were very emotional amongst even the student athletes. Coach Mazur, our soccer coach, organizing prayer services at night, and having our counseling center coming in with Father Harrington to take care of the athletes that needed special counseling, because everybody knew somebody back at that time.
Take a second to look around this sacred ground. People that I know and love are buried here. Over almost 3,000 people died here. This is sacred ground. This is the place where unbelievable heroics took place. And so, if I were you, I would take a picture of this location and hang it in my locker. Because anytime you feel like life is a little tough, anytime you think you don't want to run the extra rep or do the extra set in the weight room, think about what the people that came here on September 11th did that day.
How was your experience out here? And what do you think about 9/11 and and what happened here and all the people who passed away here?
My experience here is going good so far. I'm getting to see a lot about what happened and how it happened and the effects on people's lives. I'm loving it right now, like giving back to like coming, visiting, seeing everything is in the footprints and everybody, you know, the buildings being built. I like it. I mean, couldn't be getting no better than this.
How do you feel about being in this atmosphere right now?
Well, it's a nice atmosphere. You know, I really respect the FDNY. I like the whole, like the firemen, what they do, what they stand for. So I'm a big fan of them. My brother's actually part of FDNY, so I really like them. I really like everything about them. Well, he's been in the fire department for about 2 years now, so he told me like the training that he had to go through and whatnot, and he just said it's like it's really tough, but like they do work as a team. He said it relates to basketball, like kind of like the same.
What did they tell you about 9/11? Just tell us a little something about what they told you.
They actually stated it was one of the scariest moments of their life. It was just crazy to see them actually be there and see all the fire and all the buildings breaking down and everything.
I know everyone in the city is dying for you to become a winning team. Police headquarters is full of thousands of guys that can't wait to go up to Madison Square Garden and cheer for you. The heart of this city, the guts of this city is on the table for the taking. And if you step up and take it, this city will rally behind you because this city loves winners. So I'm glad that you guys had a chance to come here because I know not everybody's from New York. And I can't imagine you representing my school, St. John's, without coming here and getting a little bit of a taste for this sacred, sacred ground. So that's all I have to say. God bless you. We pray for you. And I hope to see you soon in the Final Four. Thank you. One, two, three.
Heroes!